way to enter 2020 by doing the second marathon of My Little Pony. Yep, this is gonna go on for the next 2 months, so I really hope that you're prepared if you did watch my video on what MLP Marathon 2 is gonna be like. So anyway, the first episode that I'm gonna be reviewing is Dragonshy. Fluttershy and the others knows that there's smoke coming from the mountains, but as it turns out, it isn't smoke. It's actually from a dragon who is sleeping during the night. And in order to save Ponyville from the smoke, they need to stop the dragon from causing the smoke. Otherwise, they'll probably have to evacuate the village. Yeah. For this being one of the earlier episodes of My Little Pony, I can easily tell that some of the ideas that they did is just giving some of the characters, mainly Fluttershy, who is the main character of this episode, some kind of development towards animals. So, they completely leave Ponyville with a montage, which is probably really entertaining to watch, and they make their way to the mountain. Now, since that this is a mainly focused Fluttershy episode, Fluttershy, it has a feel with dragons. I mean, sure, you can argue that she completely encountered Spike in the first episode of the show, but since that he was a baby dragon, she really didn't experience a really huge fire-breathing dragon. So you can really imagine that the situation that she's dealing with is just basically her character trait of being afraid of things instead of being shy of things. And I really think that this episode does a really good job since that Fluttershy, even though that she can't be a shy pony, she also has some traits on to easily have some limitations when it comes to her love towards animals. I mean, throughout the majority of the characters just going on this journey to the mountains, Fluttershy, this image alone really goes to show that this is just basically a work in progress on how you have to get used to these characters. And in all honesty, I can give them the credit for actually trying to make Fluttershy way more different than the other characters. It's just something that I really think that what this episode does good at, especially with a name called Dragonshy. So anyway, they arrive at the top of the mountain to completely confront the dragon who's completely causing all the smoke. They try to do several things like Pinkie Pie completely wearing a costume to make the dragon laugh, but unfortunately it doesn't work, especially with the other characters. But Fluttershy steps up for herself by pulling her hoof down, no pun intended, and completely tells the dragon to stop causing the smoke around her town and soon eventually all over the lands of Equestria. And the episode ends with Fluttershy, who you think might overcome her fears. It didn't. She really didn't. She's still afraid of dragons. Yeah. This episode being one of the earlier episodes of Friendship is Magic, I really think they still need to completely give some of these characters some kind of likability before we can get to know and love them in the later seasons. This episode was released in 2010, along with the next episode I'm gonna be reviewing tomorrow. And I really think that there's always a work in progress when it comes to these characters. I mean, the shipping thing, even if it may be debatable that we're in the 7th episode of the show, it still needs to be a work in progress for later seasons. And I really think that Fluttershy's character trait involving trying to make sure that everything turns out alright at the end, but at the same time, most of her friends are doing most of the work, despite the fact that some of the work that they did completely backfire on them. Fluttershy's motivations in this episode can really give you some kind of an understanding if this is one of your first episodes watching from Friendship is Magic. Even though that this episode is almost 10 years old. I really think I completely enjoy this episode because even though that it's a bit basic for what it is, it's still a work in progress to get used to these characters. I mean, through the majority of this episode, Fluttershy is completely scared of fire-breathing dragons, and the fact that she cannot stand up for herself, you can tell that she will probably be the least of what you want on your group. But since that this is my little point we'll talk about, and if you're living in this universe, you will probably pick her on her side when she completely steps up in front of the dragon and completely forces him to stop causing the smoke. I really think that the development that Flushlight gets in this episode is basically what is basically a great introduction of what people can see from our character. I would say that it's something that actually happened in the season one premiere, but with all your episodes like this, you need to probably see of what the show is gonna go when it comes to later episodes. I should probably talk about the dragon. One of the Oreo things that my old point did is that they didn't have changelings, dragons, sea ponies, or any of that kind of stuff. They only had to rely on ponies and dragons and griffins. Those are literally the only three species that they actually did in the first season. And I really think that the reason on to why they didn't give some of these characters, mainly the dragons, names, is because they're probably still new at this, and at this point in 2010, My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic wasn't that popular of a show when it comes to its audio episodes in the first season. I mean, when it comes to season 2, definitely. But I really think that audio episodes like this didn't give them the motivation to give these types of creatures unique names. I mean, they did, you can argue that they did come up with unique names in the first season when it comes to other creatures, but I really think that they probably still in a work in progress onto making Friendship is Magic really entertaining for so many people back in 2010. I mean, you could say that the Brony thing became a thing in 2010, but I think it wasn't really well known until 2011. So, I really think I could really enjoy this episode. It's not one of my favorite season 1 episodes, but since that this is a Flushlight type of episode on how that she needs development on encountering fields, especially animals that she takes care of, it really gave her the good receive. It really gave her a great development in this episode only, despite being a bit generic. So I give Dragonshy a 7 out of 10. That's one down, just 60 more to go. And I can guarantee you that you're probably gonna get sick and tired of me reviewing these episodes for the next 2 months, but I just wanted to get these over with so I don't have to do this type of marathon ever again. I'll see you guys tomorrow.